I can hear you moving around downstairs, dragging your feet as you walk back and forth through the house, running your hand over the piano keys absentmindedly as you pass by. I want to join you. I sit up slowly in my bed. It's dark outside, but there's a light glowing in the yard, and it's coming through the windows. I can hear the wind blowing the leaves around. I hear your voice downstairs, and I want to join you. Turning away, I walk down the hallway to the stairs where I sit and wait. The noises have all stopped, and I see you standing by the window with your back to me, the light from the yard wrapping around your hair. I want to say something, but I can't speak. The room starts to fade, and there's only you and the light and nothing else.
ignorance when unwittingly we do that which displeases. He takes notice when in obstinacy and in perverse willfulness I turn my back on him. I flout God, holding my fist in his face and saying, I choose my will. I know what thy will is, but I choose my will. And in arrogance, I go on. God takes notice of that. And if you are truly God's child, he'll deal with you about it. Now mark it well. What I am preaching is not popular, but I want to say it because I believe it is deeply ingrained in the book of God. God is not a grandfather who sits ensconced in heaven, and when we do that which displeases him, he smiles and says, well, it's not so bad. My friend, if you are deliberate, disobedient to God, hear me. Five pilots stopped us for it. We looked up and he said, "Glenn, I want a quote of verse. The fruit of the Spirit." No, he said, "Let me change the word. The flowers of the Spirit are love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, and some of these flowers also grow." And Glenn very thoughtfully looked at it. He said, "Which are the kind of flowers?" The sky pilot said, "Gentle.
Sometimes I can feel it in the room with me.